All right, we're going to look at a few drills today. One of the things I really emphasize to students is I never, ever go to a practice session and just shoot. I always go and shoot every single round on scored drills, timed drills, things that have both an accuracy and a time component to them, because otherwise you're pretty much just wasting ammo. And I always start a session cold, shooting some particular fairly low round count drill to see where I am on that particular day, if there's something I want to work on that particular day. So I always start out with a cold drill. I have a number of them that run between 10 and 20 rounds. One thing right now, ammunition is so expensive and hard to come by right now. We don't like to just waste it. So there are a number of ways in 10 to 20 rounds where we can get a pretty good idea of where you are on a given day and what you might need to work on. What we're going to do right now is what I call the baseline assessment drill. And what it allows you to do is get a baseline of your skills, and then you don't shoot the course over and over and over again. That's pointless. If you see something that you're not working on, doing terribly well in that particular course, work on that. Go home and do dry work on it, go to the range and work on it, and then after a couple of months, shoot the drill again, and that will give you a measurable amount of progress. So it's the term baseline is just that. It's a way to see exactly where we are, what we need to work on, and if we are in fact getting better through that work. Designed to test most, we can't test everything in 20 rounds, but we can test most of the things we need to know how to do with a defensive pistol in 20 rounds and get a pretty good idea where we are and what we need to work on. We shoot it on a B8, you can shoot it on a B8 repair center, you can shoot it on the bullseye on a LTT1 target, you can shoot it on an FBI IP1 target, doesn't matter as long as they're equivalent to a B8, which all of those are. The black consists of the X, 10, and 9 ring, then you got the 8 ring. The 8 ring, just coincidentally, is 8 inches in diameter, and it corresponds to a good solid hit on man between collarbone, diaphragm, and inside the nipples. So we don't count anything outside the 8 ring. The 7, 6, 5 are irrelevant to us, so all we care about is inside the 8 ring. Obviously, we would like them all to be in the 10 ring. The 10 ring is about 3.5 inches in diameter. That's pretty much an ocular window shot. And if the black itself is 5.5 inches in diameter, that's pretty much the equivalent of an IDPA target's head, for instance. So it's a fairly anatomically relevant target, even though it's a bullseye target. So our goal, of course, will be to keep everything inside the 10 ring. Since I'm old and crippled, I don't know if we'll be able to do that or not, but we'll see how close we can come to that. Again, it's a total of 20 rounds. It's fired at 5 and 10 yards and covers most of the stuff that we need to know. So let's back up to 5 yards and we'll take a look at the first part of it. First task is to draw and fire 5 shots in 5 seconds. You know, 5 yards, 5 shots, 5 seconds. That I find an awful lot of people who don't shoot much, you think that sounds awfully easy. Well, yeah, it might sound easy, but you're trying to keep them in the 10 ring, if you recall. So that's not exactly as easy as it sounds. So 5 shots in 5 seconds from a concealed holster. Let's see what we can do. .388. The next will be 3 rounds with the dominant hand only in 3 seconds. .230. And then 2 rounds with the non-dominant hand only in 3 seconds. And I need a magazine. Has 2 rounds in it. I now have. I'm going to step back to the 7-yard line. 7 yards, our task will be to fire 3 rounds, reload, and fire 3 more. We have a 10-second limit. Again, sounds like a lot of time, but again, we're trying to keep them in the 10 ring. So 3, reload, 3. Seconds flat, and then we'll move back here to the 10-yard line, and from 10 yards we'll fire 4 rounds in 4 seconds. So pretty much like a mini version of Hackathorn's test. 4 shots in 4 seconds. And that's it. Doesn't take but a couple minutes to run 20 rounds of ammunition. Let's go see what kind of score we got. .197 out of 200, so that's about a 99%. I guess we can deal with that. So that's a good quick and dirty test. 20 rounds again tests the ability to draw the gun from concealment, fire rapid multiple shots, shoot with a dominant hand only, shoot with a non-dominant hand only, conduct an empty gun reload on the clock, and be able to get good hits fairly quickly from 10 yards, essentially two car lengths away. So if you can shoot 95 or better on this cold, I'd say your pistol skills pretty squared away. And by working through all those different tasks, now you can see if you did not do a particular stage well, that would be what I would put the emphasis in that practice session on, trying to bring that particular skill level up. I'll settle for this today, okay?